Thank you. Something I've never quite understood are stop signs. Like, why does a stop sign have such a peculiar shape compared to other road signs? It's all octagonal and, yeah, like, other road signs are usually square or, like, rectangle or, like, you know, a square that's either rotated or not rotated or circle. So why is a stop sign an octagonal shape? Like, yeah, there is a possibility of it just being like that so that it's easier to spot, because a stop sign is very important. It can probably prevent a lot of accidents. I don't know, I've never driven a car, but that's an explanation I can make up on the spot right here. But other than that, I don't understand why a stop sign has an octagonal shape. So many orange and brown animals red. For example, the red panda, or several species of fish that are just not red and they look like brown or like very, very light red. Also, speaking of the red panda, it's not even like a panda, so both the words are incorrect. Red panda is actually close to being a ferret. But it's kind of its own category, just like one species. Every time I'm somewhere where just there is a plate of brownies. Everyone just wants the edge pieces. I never understood that, like, you know. When you make brownies, you purposely try to, like, make the dough as smooth as possible. So, people who want edge pieces are deliberately taking pieces that are, well, not smooth. Or crunchy and stuff. Why don't we just make the entire brownie crunchy and chunky and stuff? I never quite understood that for some reason, and honestly, they don't even taste that good. Also, same goes for lasagna. Lasagna. Well, everyone just wants the edge pieces for some reason, despite the fact that it's literally pasta. It's over, like, overbaked. Like, you know, it's all crunchy and tough and stuff. People still buy it, and then, you know, you have recipe like a Ragusa's like recipe, which deliberately makes every piece an edge piece, which makes even less sense. Thank you.